Charleston has a great deal of just inherent risk in the fact that where it's located, it's in the southeast, it's on the water, and it's basically already at sea level. The flooding in the Charleston area isn't just from the tide. It's from heavy rain. It's from water coming downstream from heavy rains inland. We do get a king tide if it rains during that time. It means that the water can't drain off the streets, and so it sits there. And that has a big deal of impact to traffic. It causes our traffic issues that are already pretty severe to get much worse. In 2015, we had 35 days of tidal flooding, which was at the time a record. But then in 2016, we had 50 days of tidal flooding. If you look at the projections for how that's going to increase based on the National Climate Assessment, by 2050, we could have more than 150 days of tidal flooding a year. And by 2100, every day out of the year could have tidal flooding.
Just a quarter of an inch of sea level rise. It doesn't sound like much, but when you spread that across the island, every high tide, you're talking about a quarter inch of water coming up beyond what you already had 10 years ago. It's a tremendous impact on flooding. Most of the residents were not thinking much about flooding until Joaquin back in 2015. People had water under their homes up to their knees in areas that had never really flooded before. The streets flooded to the point where we had people kayaking up and down Ashley Avenue.
CISA does a number of things, including helping provide technical assistance and organizational assistance. One of the things we also help with is helping develop and occasionally deliver what we call community engagement and stakeholder engagement, where we go out in the communities and carefully design processes to help people identify what the risks are and then help them understand what the solutions are. One of the projects that CISA is working on with Sea Grant is doing a different type of model that incorporates not just sea level rise and tidal flooding, but also stormwater flooding, rain coming off the land and into the water from various discharge points.
As we move forward, citizens, elected officials, the Sea Grant Consortium, and CISA can collectively help deal with sea level rise that we seem to be faced with. We need to keep working together to try and solve the problems that come.
I'm an engineer. I need to rely on the climate scientists to provide that kind of information to me. And I think we just need to get realistic about what we're seeing here. Folks in Charleston know that we're flooding here more often from sea level rise than we have in the past. And we really don't need to debate why that's happening, but we do need to address it. And if we wait too long, it's going to be very expensive. The information that CISA and Sea Grant has online has really helped us to illustrate to folks what we expect to see in the future. When we're working on our capital projects, we're also using the information that CISA's providing and Sea Grant to help us make decisions about where will the sea levels be several years from now and into the future 50 years from now. And we actually created a sea level rise strategy in which we use that information to take a look 50 years into the future and say, we know that we at least want to plan for a 2.5 foot sea level rise within the next 50 years. Charleston's very fortunate right now to have a very strong economy, and with that comes a lot of development that's happening throughout the city. Some of that's happening in floodplains where we're not certain that that's the best place to have that occurring. The battery's about 100 years old, it's about a mile long, and it's in somewhat of a state of disrepair. So we've been planning to do the work for a while, but now with our sea level rise study and with other information that we've gotten from CISA and NOAA, we're planning to build that wall 2.5 feet taller. What I've seen after 3 floods in 2 years is that our citizens, they're very supportive of a program that's gonna minimize flooding. We've been very lucky that they have approved tax increases and stormwater fees that allow us to do the improvements that we're making. And I believe that they want us to do more.
A lot of times people think that climate change and sea level rise are really political issues. The thing is here, it's not, because we realize it's happening now and those impacts are occurring now. And that if we still want to be the kind of region that we are now, in the future, we have to start doing things and start finding the solutions.